You know, one of the things that I talk to women about is actually having a gratitude journal, because we're always just ripping and running from pillar to post. And a lot of times we're going through life and we're just not conscious. We're not aware of the blessings that are all around us. And the things that we really pay attention to are those things that annoy us. So you think about in your relationship, you think about all the frustrating things that your spouse does, but you really don't hone in or zero in on all the good things. And so like with a gratitude journal for your life, you can actually begin to document the things you're grateful for in your relationship, like the things that you love about him or her that you seldom say, and maybe you think about it in a whim or in passing or, you know, as you're walking past each other, but it never actually gets to your lips and comes out where your spouse can hear it. Start to document these things so that you're aware of all the blessings that are around.
Now, if you're from the church, all right, if you've been born and raised in a church, there's a song they used to sing, Count Your Blessings, Name Them One by One.
Oh.
Count your blessings and see what the Lord or what God has done. It's been so long. Something like that. But think about that.
I never heard that song in my whole life.
Well, because you just got saved 2 days ago.
That's a lie.
You are wretch undone, but we delivered you. But see, here's the reality, right?
I was delivered, but anyway.
If we can thank God for all that he's done, yes. Think about it. If you had a gratitude journal, you would probably have to buy volumes and volumes and volumes of things to write down, because God has continued to bless us. Well, guess what? The relationship we have with him is a template for the relationship that we have with one another. Mm-hmm. And so if we can praise him and adore him and thank him, then why can't we show appreciation and praise and thankfulness towards our spouse for the things that they do in the relationship?
Husbands, love your wives like Christ loved the church. So that's a great example, right? If we can praise and give honor, you can actually praise and give honor to your spouse and let them know how much you appreciate them. And nothing wrong with writing it down. When we talk about those gratitudes, we do them in the morning. Mm-hmm. We either speak them out loud. Thank you, Lord, for this day. Thank you, Lord, for my legs. Thank you, Lord, I could walk. Thank you for this food on the table. Well, could you thank the wife that scrambled the eggs and put the bacon and the toast on the table too? Like, you know what what's always gotten under my skin, just bear with me, is in the church, when you would give and bless and help build a church and they would only thank the Lord. Like, I get it. I know all blessings cometh from the Lord, but could you thank me too? Because I wrote some checks. Can I get a thank you? I'm just saying.
No, you're right. You're right.
Sometimes we can discredit our spouses when they're the ones that are doing so much. And we so easily give credit to other people. We so easily give credit to, you know, people at work and our boss and our friends for doing the minimum. But the one that's putting up with you and your idiosyncrasies and your issues, they don't get no respect.
You didn't preach the sermon. If I had a dollar, I'd put it on this table.
Okay.
But think about it. When you're praying to God, one of the first things you do is you thank him. Enter his courts with thanksgiving. It's been so long. When you thank God.
COVID? Is that a COVID symptom?
But when you thank God, you know, he's appreciative of it. So take the time to form your lips to say thank you to your spouse.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you, Hassani.
Thank you for the big things. Thank you for the small
things.
Thank
you, Hassani.
You're welcome, Daniel. Thank you, Daniel.
Oh, okay.
Thank you for that meal you cooked last night.
You're welcome.
Thank you for looking beautiful every single day and being intentional. Like,
you're
those
so
are the
welcome.
Things you want to do. Like, the things that you normally do, give thanks. Formulas to suit. But many of us come from environments where we never saw it.
Yeah.
We never saw it in our household, and so it's not a part of our DNA, and so therefore it's a struggle.
Right.
Like, we hear so many people say, well, I didn't see my mom compliment my dad or my dad compliment my mom, so that's why I don't do it. I mean, you know it. I didn't told you when we got married. How many more times do I need to tell you? Again and again and again.
Yes.
And so you want to take the time to appreciate, and you can do it in a number of different creative ways.
Yes.
You can verbally articulate it. You can send texts throughout the course of the day. You can write small notes and leave them in places.
Yes.
You can even buy a card or write a letter and then mail it to your own
house.
You
can even put sticky notes all throughout the house that lead to like a box that has address in it. And then in the box it says, put this dress on. And then you put this dress on. And then when you get the dress on, you go upstairs and you see another note that says, go to the front door. There's a car waiting for you. And so you're like, oh, and you go to the front door and you sit, and then a limo pulls up to you. Then you get in that limo and you drive and you don't know where you're going, but then you end up at a five-star, the five-diamond restaurant, and there your husband is standing there in a tux waiting for you. And do I need to go
on? Is she talking to you or is she indirectly talking to me? I don't know what's happening here.